कृष्णाय वासुदेवाय देवकी नंदनाय च नंदगोपकुमाराय गोविंदाय नमो नमः। कैंटो 3 चैप्टर 22 टेक्स्ट 1 एंड 2। मैत्रेय उवाच एवं आविष्कृताशेष गुणकर्मोदयो मुनीं सव्रीड इवतं सम्राट् उपारतं वाचः। श्री मैत्रेय सेड, आफ्टर डिस्क्राइबिंग द ग्रेटनेस ऑफ द एम्परर्स मैनीफोल्ड एक्टिविटीज एंड क्वालिटीज एंड एक्टिविटीज The sage became silent, and the emperor, feeling modesty, addressed him as follows. Manuruvacha Brahma srijatsva mukato yusman atma paripsaya chandomayastapo vidya योगयुक्तानलंपटान् मनोरुवाच ब्रह्मा सृजत्स्व मुखतो युष्मन् आत्मपरीप्सया छन्दोमयस्तपो विद्या योगयुक्तानलंपटान् मनोरुवाच ब्रह्मा सृजत्स्व मुखतो युष्मान् आत्मपरीप्सया छन्दोमयस्तपो विद्या योगयुक्तानलंपटान् मनोरुवाच ब्रह्मा सृजत्स्व मुखतो युष्मान् आत्मपरीप्सया छन्दोमयस्तपो विद्या योगयुक्तानलंपटान् मनोरुवाच ब्रह्मा सृजत्स्व मुखतो युष्मान् आत्मपरीप्सया छन्दोमयस्तपो विद्या योगयुक्तानलंपटान् मनोरुवाच ब्रह्मा सृजत्स्व मुखतो युष्मान् आत्मपरीप्सया छन्दोमयस्तपो विद्या योगयुक्तानलंपटान् मनुः मनु वाच सेड ब्रह्मा लॉर्ड ब्रह्मा असृजत क्रिएटेड सो मुखतः फ्रॉम हिज फेस युष्मान् यू ब्राह्मणस् आत्मपरीप्सया टू प्रोटेक्ट हिमसेल्फ बाय एक्सपैंडिंग छंदमयः द फॉर्म ऑफ द वेदास तपः योग विद्या योगयुक्तान् फुल ऑफ ऑस्टेरिटी नॉलेज एंड मिस्टिक पावर अलंपटान् अवर्स टू सेंस रेटिफिकेशन। Translation and purport by His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Shri Gurupad Shri Prabhupad Ki Jai. Manu replied, to expand himself in Vedic knowledge, Lord Brahma, the personified Veda, from his face created the Brahmanas, who are full of anxiety, austerity, full of austerity, knowledge and mystic power, and averse to sense gratification. Purport. The purpose of the Vedas is to propagate the transcendental knowledge of the Absolute Truth. The Brahmanas were created from the mouth of the Supreme Person, and therefore they are meant to spread the knowledge of the Vedas in order to spread the glories of the Lord. In Bhagavad Gita also, Lord Krishna says that all the Vedas are meant for understanding the Supreme Personality of Godhead. It is especially mentioned here, Yoga Yuktan Alampatan, that Brahmanas are full of mystic power and are completely averse to sense gratification. Actually, there are two kinds of occupations. One occupation in the material world is sense gratification, and the other occupation is spiritual activity to satisfy the Lord by His glorification. Those who engage in sense gratification are called demons, and those who spread the glorification of the Lord or satisfy the transcendental senses of the Lord are called demigods. It is specifically mentioned here that the Brahmanas are created from the face of the cosmic personality or Virata Purusha. Similarly, the Kshatriyas are said to be created from his arms, the Vaishyas are created from his waist, and the Shudras are created from his legs. Brahmanas are especially meant for austerity, learning and knowledge, and averse to all kinds of sense gratification. Hare Krishna. ओम ज्ञानतिमिरन्धस्य ज्ञानाञ्जनशलाकय चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः श्रीचैतन्यमनोभीष्टं स्थापितं येन भूतले स्वयं रूप कदा मह्यं ददाति स्वपदान्तिकं वन्देहं श्रीगुरो श्रीयुतामृतकमलं श्रीगुरोन्वैष्णवांश्च श्रीरूपं सागरजातां सह गणरघुनाथान्वितं तं सजीवम् साद्वैतं सावधूतं परिजनासहितं कृष्णचैतन्यदेवं श्रीराधाकृष्णपादान् सह गणललिता श्रीविशाखान्वितं नमो विष्णुपादाय कृष्णप्रेष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदान्तस्वामिनिति नाम्ने नमस्ते सारस्वतीदेवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेषशून्यवादी पाश्चात्यदेशतारिणे नमो महावदन्याय कृष्ण प्रेम प्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्ण चैतन्य नाम्ने गोरत्रसे नमः हे कृष्ण करुणा सिंधो दीनबंधो जगत्पते गोपेश गोपिका कांत राधा कांत नमोस्तुते तप्त कांचन गौरांगी राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी वृषभानुसुते देवी प्रणमामि हरिप्रिय वाञ्छाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपा सिंधुभ्य एव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौरभक्तवृंद हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे मुखं करोति वाचां पंगुं वंदे श्रीगुरुमेत्रपातनं वंदे श्रीगुरुदिनतानं Hare Krishna. So here in these two verses, the position of Brahmanas is being described, the exalted position of the Brahmanas. Like Srila Prabhupada used to say that the purpose of ISKCON Society is to create first class devotees. Isn't it? You have heard this statement many times. So who is a first class devotee? It is Brahmanas. So this first class, second class, third class, fourth class, and below. So these first four classes belong to the civilized order. So they are called as that's called as Varnashrama system. Those who follow this Varnashrama system are called as civilized personalities because they follow the rules and regulations meant for humanity. But those people who do not follow the rules and regulations meant for humanity, they are called as outcast, which is beyond this Varnashrama system, outside of the system. So they are like chandalas, the dog eaters, and kiratas, hunas, andhras, shabras, all those categories of people are there. So they are called as outcast. And even in this civilized community, the topmost people are the Brahmanas because they have knowledge. Knowledge is mightier than the sword. So Kshatriyas are experts with sword, but Brahmanas are expert in knowledge. So the Kshatriya's power without the guidance of Brahmanas is not of much use. So the passion has to be directed by goodness. So Brahmanas are in goodness, Kshatriyas are in passion. Vaishyas are in mixed mode of passion and ignorance, and Shudras are in mode of ignorance. So that is the categorization. According to the modes of nature which people have cultivated, accordingly their nature is formed. Some people are Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra, like that. So Krishna says this in Bhagavad Gita, Chaturvarnyam Maya Srishtam Guna Karma Vibhagasha, not on Janma Karma Vibhagasha. He says Guna Karma Vibhagasha. What kind of qualities they are developing or they are exhibiting and what kind of activities they are inclined to. Accordingly their Varna is determined and accordingly their occupations are determined. It is natural that a person does certain activity according to his nature. So that becomes his Varna. It is not defined by birth as what is happening nowadays. Nowadays people label a person based on his birth. Okay, he is born in a Brahman family, so he is permanently Brahmana. He is born in a Vaishya family, so he is a Vaishya. There is good chance that the people born in that family can become Brahmanas or Vaishyas, but not necessarily. Right? Like people sitting here, now all of you are engineers. How many of your father is an engineer? Kisi ka father engineer hai? Nahi. Some places it may be that the father is also engineer. Right? So there are many doctors, but how many doctors' parents are doctors? Cannot. So we cannot determine a person's nature by his birth. We have to determine based on his activities and his nature. Suppose a person born in a Brahmana family is showing some other guna, then that other guna becomes his actual guna. Narad Muni tells this in Bhagavatam, Srimad Bhagavatam, 7th canto at the later chapters. Yasya yal lakshanam prokto pumsam, he says that very beautiful verse, I'd like to share. Yasya yal lakshanam proktam pumso varnabhivyanjakam yadanatryapi drushyeta tattenaiva vinirdesheta. So if a person is showing varna abhivyanjaka, some other nature of some other varna, a person born in Brahman family is showing the nature of other varna, then what he should do? Yad annatrapi drushyeta tattenaiva vinirdesheta. So that other nature which is showing, that becomes his varna. Okay, so this is what is told by Narada Muni in 7.11.35. So very, and this whole chapter is about varna and ashram. So Narada Muni describes Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra, and then finally says that this is actually, if in case there is a difference in his character, then that has to be his varna. Example given is Bharat Maharaj, Rishabdeh had many sons, 100 sons. Out of that, 9 people became sannyasis. I think about 10 people became kshatriyas and 80 people became, about 81 people, 11 people became kshatriyas and 80 people became brahmanas. So this is how the, in one family, people of different varnas can be present. So it is based upon qualities, not based upon birth. So that is one point to understand. And in this Varna and Ashrama, the from the face of the Lord came the Brahmanas. From the arms of the Lord came the Kshatriyas. And from the belly came the Vaishyas. And from the leg, Shudras appeared. So in this way, that's the way they manifested in this world. That's what is described here. Brahma asrjat swamukhato. From his face, Lord Brahma created you people, Yushman, Atma Paripsaya. Why did Brahma create them? So that he can protect himself. Atma Paripsaya. To protect himself by expanding. So Brahma is the original Brahmana and he expanded himself into other Brahmanas by creating many Brahmanas so that the Brahmanical culture can be preserved. So So that is the reason he expanded. And Chandomayas Tapo Vidya, Yoga Yuktan, Alampatans. And what is the nature of these Brahmanas? The nature of these Brahmanas is, the qualities are Tapo Vidya Yoga Yuktan. Brahmanas are austere. And Vidya, they are knowledge. Yoga Yuktan, they have mystic powers. जय श्री श्री जगन्नाथ बलदेव सूत्र मैया की जय, श्री श्री गौरिता की जय, श्री लक्ष्मण सिंह देव की जय, श्री प्रभुपाद की जय. सो ए ब्राह्मण शुड बी ऑस्टियर. इफ ए ब्राह्मण इज इंडल्जिंग इन सेंस ग्रेटिफिकेशन देन ही इज नॉट ए ब्राह्मण. राइट, ए पर्टिकुलर वर्ण हैज सर्टन क्वालिटीज, ही हैज टू शो दोज क्वालिटीज, देन ओनली ही विल बी कॉल्ड एज अ ब्राह्मण. शमो दमः तपः शौचम् शान्तिरार्जवम् एव च ज्ञानम् विज्ञानम् आस्तिक्यम् ब्रह्मकर्म स्वभावजम्. दिस आर द क्वालिटीज ऑफ ब्राह्मण इज मेंशन इन भगवद्गीता चैप्टर 18. सो इफ समबडी इज नॉट एग्जिबिटिंग दिस क्वालिटीज देन ही इज नॉट ए प्रॉपर ब्राह्मण. एंड दैट्स व्हाट इट मीन्स. सो हियर इट इज सेड दे आर तपस्वीज, दे डू ऑस्टेरिटीज. Already austerities like fasting, austerities like, you know, doing services for the Lord, right? So, and they are having Vidya. And what is Vidya? Vidya is actually spiritual knowledge, Krishna consciousness knowledge. So, and that they will propagate. Yoga Yuktan Alampatan. So, they'll have mystic power and Alampatan. They are averse to sense gratification. Lampata means a cheater. Alampata means one is not indulging in sense gratification. So that's what is told here. Chandomaya tapa vidya. Brahmaji is called as the Vedas personified. Chandomaya. He is a personification of all the Vedas. The Lord instructed all the Vedas to him, and from him, all the Vedas we are getting. So we are coming in Brahma Madhva Gaudiya Sampradaya. So he has a very important position for us, Lord Brahmaji. And from him we are getting this knowledge. So this is what Prabhupada tells in this purport. So I will focus on one particular aspect here. That Brahmaji is creating these Brahmanas for the sake of propagating Vedic wisdom. So Brahmanas are meant to speak and propagate Vedic culture. That is the duty. So there is one point which I have written here called preservation happens by propagation. If you want to preserve something, then you have to propagate it. Then it will get preserved. Especially Vedas. Generally, if you want to preserve some jewel, you keep it secret somewhere so that you preserve it. If you show it, people will steal it. That is the quality of jewels, valuables. But here, Vedic knowledge is such a thing, if you keep it secret, rotting in the library, then it will get lost. How to preserve Vedic knowledge? By propagating. More people have this knowledge with them, then there is good chance that it will be preserved. But if it is one person only, or in one book which is there in the library, which nobody is reading, it is getting dust and getting decayed. So how will it get preserved? It will get lost. So the books which are kept untouched, they will get lost. But the books which are actively read and discussed, they will be preserved and propagated. So that's why Srila Prabhupada, he wrote Bhagavatam in English, and then he said that every day you should have Bhagavatam class. Because if this knowledge is being discussed every day by devotees, then it will be preserved. Not only preserved, but also propagated far and wide. That you can see in the last 50 years, after Prabhupada wrote this Bhagavatam and he has preached all over the world, so many people have become devotees, so many have got benefited by reading this book. Right? So that is the nature of preaching. When you preach the knowledge, it is preserved and it goes on for a long, long time in the human society. One analogy is given in Bhagavatam only, that generally there are pathways, like in this mountain you will see that people walk on a particular path and you can see that pathway, no grass grows there. And on the side there may be grasses, but on that path there will be no grasses. But if people stop walking for 1 or 2 years in that path, what will happen? And grass will grow, weeds will come, and then whole area will get covered and the path will be lost. People will not be able to see the path, so they will not be able to reach the destination. Here it is very small mountain, but if you go to thick jungles, so the pathways are very important, otherwise you'll get lost. Which path to go, like hundreds of acres of thick jungle, and through that you have to pass. So the pathways are very important, but if nobody is walking and in the rainy season it gets covered up by green grass, then people will not have the way. Similarly, if Vedic literatures are also not read and not propagated, what will happen? It will get lost. So it is very important that we actually, for imagine another case, if for next 10 years people stop reading, or for one generation people stop reading and preaching Bhagavad Gita, what will happen? Everybody stops reading Gita, then what will happen? So there is nobody to propagate, the knowledge will get lost. I was talking to one doctor, Sutta Bapuru, he was telling that Prabhu, there are so many home remedies for diseases by using like turmeric or ginger and pepper, and you can make so many herbal remedies that most of the diseases you can cure at home only. No need to go to doctor to take tablets. But what will happen if one generation doesn't know this, the knowledge doesn't come from the parents to the son, and he doesn't know, then what will happen? It will get lost. So next generation will not know. So because this knowledge has not been propagated, it cannot be preserved. So or you have to read some books where something is written, and then you have to again learn it, isn't it? So that's why it's very important to preach Krishna consciousness, these shastras. And who can do this preaching? Mainly Brahmanas. So that's why Prabhupada, when he went for preaching, he was very focused. He wanted to create first class people, the leaders, the Brahmanas. So he picked up people from even the lowest category of humanity and made them highest. Okay. So you may wonder that how can people born in hippie families be elevated to the position of Brahmanas? It is possible. How is it possible? By training. By training, it is possible. There is one verse in Bhagavatam, 2746. ते वै विदन्त्यतितरन्ति च देवमाया स्त्रीशूद्रहूनशबरा अपि पापजीवाः यद्यद्भुतक्रमपरायणशीलशिक्षा तीर्यग्जनापि किमु श्रुतधारणाये. वेरि ब्यूटिफुल् वर्स्. ते वै विदन्ति अतितरन्ति च देवमाया. ते मीन्स् प्रीवियस् वर्स्. So many other the surrendered souls, the great devotees, Devai Vidanti Atitaranti Cha Devamaya. They can overcome this Devamaya, which is Maya Shakti. Devi Hesha Gunamayi Mama Maya Duratyaya. Very difficult to cross. Maya is so alluring. Even for devotees, practitioners, Maya allures, it's very difficult. But these great personalities who have surrendered to the Lord, they can cross. Tevai vidanti atitaranti cha deva maya. Even stri, shudra, huna, shabara, api papa, jiva. These are all the names of low class categories. The stri, woman, because they are more emotional, they are more, not very rational. So they are also considered to be less intelligent. Stri, Shudra, Huna. Prabhupada calls Hunas as the mountaineers, those who stay in the mountain regions. Huna. शबरा, शबरा इज साइबेरियन, स्त्री शूद्र हून शबर अपि पाप जीवा एंड मेनी अदर कैटेगरीज ऑफ लोअर पर्सनैलिटीज लाइक चांडालास एंड अदर्स. यदि अद्भुत क्रम परायण शील शिक्षा, अद्भुत क्रम इज कृष्णा इज अनदर नेम, वन हु डस अमेजिंग एक्टिविटीज, हिज नेम इज उरुक्रम और अद्भुत क्रम, बोथ आर सेम. यदि अद्भुत क्रम परायण, अद्भुत कर्म परायण इज अ डिवोटी, शील शिक्षा, इफ somebody gets trained under a pure devotee, and even this fallen categories, they will also become liberated. Tiryak janapi, even animals will also, even those who are not human beings, they will also get benefit. Tiryak janapi kimu shruta dharanaye, so if by faithfully serving pure devotees and hearing from them, animals and even fallen humanity will get elevated, what to speak of surrendered souls, right? Surrendered souls, even from the groups leading sinful lives, such as women, the labor class, the mountaineers and the Siberians, or even the birds and beasts, can also know about the science of Godhead and become liberated from the clutches of illusory energy by surrendering unto the pure devotees of the Lord and by following in the footsteps in devotional service. So there is an importance of training. If you see 2 days back, Karunamurthy was giving a class. In that Prabhupada writes the word training 4 times. In the institution of 4 varnas and 4 ashramas, there are regular training principles for different classes. It means nobody can become a Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra, but just like that, you have to train him. And then he says, just like electrical engineers are properly trained, similarly, varna and ashrama should be trained. And then he says, again he says, they are properly trained. When there is no such training, one simply claims that because he is born in a Brahmana or Kshatriya family, he is therefore a Brahmana or Kshatriya, even though he performs the duties of a Shudra. So training 4 times before this day. Means it's a matter of training. If one properly gets trained from a pure devotee, then he can change his varna also. It's possible. So you can see how Prabhupada did. By his preaching and by training, he elevated even low people. He changed the modes actually. Basically what happens by practicing Krishna consciousness, the modes change. A tamasic person becomes rajasic and then sattvic. So by the change of the modes, he can change his nature. So that's how it is. Of course it is difficult by one's endeavor. By our own endeavor we cannot do. But by the mercy of the Lord and the devotees it is possible. Another Shastric example you can think of is Vishwamitra. He was actually a Kshatriya. So, but he had to struggle a lot. He did so much of austerities, tapasya. He fell down 2 times, 3 times. And then finally he became a Brahmarishi, a Brahmana. It's difficult, but by the training under a pure devotee and the mercy of the Lord, it is possible that one can change one's modes, which is otherwise very difficult. So that's why these Brahmanas, especially ISKCON devotees, should preach Krishna consciousness to preserve and propagate Vedic culture. And Prabhupada in ISKCON society, he made wonderful programs for this. One is book distribution, where we go out and give so many books out. In case in somebody's home book is lost, in somebody else's home you can find, isn't it? So if you put Bhagavad Gita and Bhagavatam in everybody's home, we can easily preserve this Vedic literature. Agar ek, suppose in one country they ban this book, say Hamara Dharma atheism, like China. If they say that our dharma is atheism, and then still in other countries the books will be there. And somebody will take it up and then preach and then again propagate Krishna consciousness. So that's why Vaisheshika Prabhu was using this technique in Silicon Valley. He was telling that these are very sacred books. We want to preserve them. You just keep in your home. We want to keep these books in many, many homes. You just keep it, it will get preserved. With that technique, that was a tactic he was using to put Bhagavatam sets in different homes in America. And you can see that they are the top number for book distribution. One of the top, actually. Always in top three they are. Although it's a small community, but big book distribution. So that is his enthusiasm. So when you have to preserve something, you have to propagate. So you have to preserve Vedic culture, then what we should do? You have to propagate Vedic culture. Like wearing dhoti kurta, tilak, putting shika, putting tilak, and all devotional things. You have to preserve, then you have to propagate. You have to tell many, many people do these things. When His Holiness Bhakti Madhuri Govind Maharaj had come here, of course he is no more. So when he came here, he saw some 3-4 people sitting in pant shirt. He said, "Where is dhoti kurta? Go change and come." Then they said, "Actually, we came from office." "So what is the problem? We should keep on dhoti kurta in your home, in your bag. After coming from office, you should change and then sit in classes." Because he was telling that, no, if we are only not following, then who will follow? So that is the point. And he's one of the ambitions when he was alive. Of course, he's no more, but when he was alive, he wanted to make every Indian wear dhoti kurta. So that was his ambition. So if you propagate this, and if you propagate the importance of Vedic culture, then it will get preserved in the long run. So anything you want to preserve, propagate it. So nowadays, because of COVID, we cannot do physical preaching, propagation, but you can online propagation, online preaching. Right? So, very important point actually. So therefore the Brahmanas were created from the mouth of the Supreme Lord. Therefore they are meant to spread the knowledge of the Vedas in order to spread the glories of the Lord. So Radhishankara was telling sometimes that especially those who are preachers, brahmacharis and all, they should also see that how much time they are preaching Krishna consciousness. Apart from sadhana, reading and all those things, how much voice time he is giving for service. In Christian religion they have this calculation, it seems that they calculate how much time you spoke about from Bible, so that they calculate. So more you are doing it, then more you are serving. Similarly, we also should check at our own capacity, each one of us, we have to see that how much preaching I'm doing. At every evening, maybe at least some program should be there so that we give Krishna to others. So more we preach, automatically more people will become devotees. It's proportionate. More time you spend preaching, then more people will become devotees. Of course, also purity, practice, sadhana, that has to be there. Otherwise, it will become like an empty shell. Right? Preaching is going on, but there is no power in that. So preaching should be done with the power of purity. Then only it will have effect on others. So we are meant for spreading the Krishna consciousness. So one is the occupation of material world, which is sense gratification, and the other is spiritual activity to satisfy Lord by His glorification. So those who engage in sense gratification are called demons, and those who spread the glorification of the Lord or satisfy the transcendental senses of the Lord are called demigods. Okay, and it is specifically mentioned here that Brahmanas are created from the face of the cosmic personality. See, some people, when they think that Brahmanas come from face, Shudras come from the legs, so they think that the legs are lower portion, so Shudras are lower. That kind of conception they have. But actually Lord's form is absolute. There is no difference between His leg and mouth and hands. Functions may be different, but actually they are serving one common cause. Right? Now we cannot say that the leg is lower portion, it is useless, we cut it. No. leg is only carrying the stomach and the hands and the head. It doesn't mean that leg is useless. It is also playing its part. It is important. So without the legs, other three become handicapped. They cannot function. And without the legs, without the stomach, the three categories will not get nourishment. Right? See, Shudras help Brahmanas, Kshatriyas, Vaishyas in all the activities. Generally, there in 1,000 people, there is one Brahmana, there are 9 Vaishyas, then 9 Kshatriyas, 99 Vaishyas, and 900 Shudras. So that is the, right? I think it's 999 and 1, total 1,000. One Brahmana, 9 Kshatriyas, 90 Vaishyas, and 900 Shudras. That is the general proportion. So one Brahmana has such intelligence that he can engage this 999 people. So he has that much plans, he has so many projects and so much vision of engaging their nature accordingly in Lord's service. So he is called as a Brahmana. So without these 900 people, these three people cannot do anything. Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya. And without Vaishyas, whole economic system will be imbalanced, because they are the ones who are feeding other three sections. And they, Vaishyas, they give charity to Brahmanas. Then they give tax to Kshatriya, so that the king can have money for taking care of the kingdom, for social welfare activities. And they pay salary to Shudras. In this way, they are only giving all the economic support to all the, because Brahmanas don't earn wealth, nor do the Kshatriyas. Kshatriyas collect tax. Paisa do hum aapka raksha karenge. So they use that money in protecting the citizens. And now without Kshatriyas, the Brahmanas, Vaishyas and Shudras will not have protection. Kshat trayate iti Kshatriya. Kshat means troubles. Those who protect people from troubles, they are Kshatriya. So Brahmanas, although they have intelligence, they don't have physical power, so they will not be able to protect themselves from enemy attacks. So that's why Kshatriyas are required. And without Brahmanas, all three will not have any direction. So they will do whatever they want and engage in sense gratification. So these four are equally important. But however, the head is the most important, because without leg one can live, still the body can survive. Society can survive. Although there may be some imbalance, some discomfort, but still they can survive. Without hand, still they can survive. Without stomach, still they can sustain. There are people without stomach who eat little bit every 1 hour and they survive. But without head, have you seen somebody without head walking? No, not possible. So that's why head is the most important part of the society. So Prabhupada used to say the headless society. You read this term, the headless society. Means what? Society without Brahmanas. That's called headless society. So Prabhupada used to say that most of the countries are headless society now, because there are no trained people. So we are here to create this head, this people who know the Shastras and who can teach Shastras. So that is the purpose of this movement, to create leaders. So in this way, Prabhupada is to preach Krishna consciousness. So these are some of the points which we wanted to share here today. Basically, today we discussed about the four Varnas, Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra, and their interdependency, and also how the Brahmanas are meant to preach and propagate Krishna consciousness. So when you propagate Krishna consciousness, it can be preserved. For one generation, if you don't read or preach, then the knowledge will get lost and it will be very difficult to access. That's what happened after Lord Chaitanya. Chaitanya Charitamrita was written after Lord Chaitanya, but it was lost. It was not visible anywhere because people were not preaching. But then Bhaktivinoda Thakur found it, then he preached, then he printed and he propagated through printing press. So then it's preserved now. But if you don't preach now also, then you will see after 50 years or 100 years, what will happen? It will stop, the preaching will not happen. Okay, Hare Krishna. Any reflections or any questions? Yes, Guru.